Hola folks, Rich, AWOL Mallorca again, and I'm back in the mountains with Mallorca for the first time in 2017, and it is stunning as you may have already seen. So it's been raining pretty much since the 22nd or 23rd of December, I think. Plus we had some snow. Not a lot down sea level, although it did fall, just didn't settle. But up here, it was quite thick on the tops apparently. So unfortunately my truck was out of action, so I couldn't get up here to see it. But that's the reason why it's so wet. Month of rain and snow melt equals stunning torrents. You've hopefully seen some footage so far that you might recognise from my long distance GR221 video, which is hopefully up by now, and if you haven't seen it, go and have a look. But yeah, that was 7th of December, over 5 days, and we came up through here on the 4th, and it was totally different. That was all bone dry. So hopefully you've seen some clips of it now with all the water rushing down, and clips of it 6 or 7 weeks ago. Complete and utter difference. I'd like to stress, it's not normally like this. We've had an exceptionally wet winter, which we needed. Not sure if the GoPro's picking it up, but the noise of that water in the background is spectacular. It's unbelievable. Not quite Steel Falls, which you went to see last year, but yeah, it's not bad. That pyramid, volcanic type looking peak is Puig Llofra. Very much doubt I pronounced that right. It's L'Ofre. And the plan is, rough plan that it be, go to the top of that, for the views. Hopefully there'll still be some. I'm not sure, the weather looks like it might be moving in. And then descend down the north side of it, I think it is, back down the trail. But instead of coming back down to reservoir level, where I'll be starting, I carry on along the Coll, along the ridge, to a place called Coll de Gats. And then, fingers crossed, stop there. We shall see. The footpath is now a stream. Complete with waterfalls. There we are. Hopefully you can see Puig Mayor with a bit of snow still on top and a very full embassment de Cuba. That is mad how much water has fallen in the last few weeks. Absolutely crazy to fill that up. I didn't believe it when people told me, but that's definitely full. Mad. Hopefully tomorrow I'll drop down this ridge here. So here's Lofra, which hopefully I'm going to go up in a minute. Then walk along the ridge there and stop over there between the two peaks. And then tomorrow descend down, take a walk around the reservoir, and then probably back that way, back to Sawyer and the truck. Just collected some water to filter and boil later for dinner. So is the Coll de Gats up there. Decided it's probably a better idea. Go down today, see the, have a look around the reservoir, and then go up from the other side along the Coll. Stay there hopefully tonight, and then tomorrow do the rest of the ridge. Puig, and then back down to Sawyer in the morning. That is absolutely mental. It's gone from being at a point where I've never seen it as low to a point where I don't ever recall seeing it that high in the space of a few weeks. That's a lot of water. Another first for me. I've not once seen these overflows overflowing. Mad. It's all running off down towards Inca and, well, onto the flatlands and flooding it. Off the beaten path now. This one's very little used. I think mostly by I guess you call them fell runners. You come up here, run the ridge, and then back round the reservoir. Not a bad view. So, this is what I've got to deal with for the next 45 minutes, I think it is. Really rocky. And when you're walking through these grasses, you got to make sure that there's solid ground below you, because holes have swallowed a few people up in these hills. So I've been up here twice before, no, three times. But twice I've camped at Coll de Gats. Second time, I actually managed to get Claire to come up here. I don't know how. Don't really know why I thought it was a good idea. But she made it. She bloody made it. Yeah. I don't think she'd do it again though. Now you can see behind me how quick that weather moves in up here. Same with anywhere. So this is the worst bit. I'm gonna get to the top of here. Carry on to Coll de Gats, get there as quick as possible. See what's happening with the weather and then call it from there, because from there on it's not too bad. And I know the route, especially once you get down to back down to that track back into Sawyer. It's a footpath all the way up, a stone footpath as you saw. So I'll just get wet. So I'm gonna get up here pronto and see what it's like. Made it, well, made it onto the top of the ridge. The first putch, I think there's four along here, peaks, that is Saratita, which is 1,113 meters, I think. So that's where I'm aiming for first. And then onward to camp. To the east coast of the island, Pudranda and all that, Bay of Palma, Palma itself down there. Yeah, one of the best views of the reservoirs you get unless you take a helicopter. Quite a few people down there having a walk around, but up here, it's just me and the goats. Saratata, 1,113 meters. It's about 14 k's from Sawyer and 4.5 hours, yeah, from about 50 meters above sea level, I think. I'm pretty chuffed with that, but not quite there yet. It's actually looking like the weather's not going to be too bad. I've had a look on a few sites and they all say it probably is going to rain, but it's only going to be like a couple of millimeters, if that. So yeah, I think we should be all right. Well, you'll be fine because you're watching. I think I should be all right. I'll let you know tomorrow. I guess if you're watching, then I am okay. But I won't know until tomorrow. It's pretty cool. Looks like somebody's created a little bivvy spot. The wind is predominantly from this direction, so that'll keep you quite sheltered in a bivvy bag. So here we are at boggy Coll de Gats. You can probably see all the water behind me. But there is a dry raised patch here. So I'll probably plonk the tent there. But it's only 3 o'clock, so I'm probably gonna wait until 5, even though I wanna get in. And it's not too cold up here. About 8 degrees at the moment. So it should probably drop quite nicely tonight, although I've got this wall here. Yeah, I'm out of my sweaty clothes and into my new Rab down jacket. Can't remember the name, but I'll put it at the bottom of the screen for you. So far so good with this. It's absolutely amazing. Obviously I haven't taken it camping with me or anything yet, but bought it when I was at home for Christmas and it was pretty damn cold there and I wore it the whole time and didn't suffer at all. So yeah, all good. I'm gonna put a pot of water on to boil for a coffee, keep me nice and warm, have something to eat, and then yeah, just chill out for a bit. So I'll catch you in a bit. Just got the tent pitched. There she is. The laser competition one. Only the third outing, I think. Wales, Scotland, and now here. And stroke of luck, literally just as soon as I got everything in, it started raining. Not heavy, but that's all moving in now. Right, show you around quickly. I'm not sure if I've shown you the tent before. Laser competition one, as I said. Nice bright yellow interior, which was really bright at like 4 o'clock in the morning in up in Wales. Can't remember, Bedgellert. That was incredible. It might have been 4:30, but yeah, it was so bright. Plenty of room. I've got me in here and my pack to keep it off this mud. Right, so we got one of those gold foil emergency blankets which I used on GR221 that one night that we did the wild camping, and it was unbelievable how much it shielded me from the cold from the ground. So I thought I'd put that down. I probably should have put it underneath the inner, but it was muddy anyway because I've been pretty lazy and haven't cleaned it. And we've got my Thermarest Neo Air, which you've seen before, the SOL bivvy bag, and my Vango Ultralight 900. So yeah, I should be pretty snug in there tonight. I don't know what the temperature is at the moment. Temperature is about 5 degrees, but it started warming up because obviously now it's in the tent. So yeah, 5 degrees plus wind chill. If I was on the other side of this wall, it'd be pretty bloody cold tonight, but yeah, should be good. catch in a bit. You can't see it, but hopefully you can hear it. Beautiful noise of rain on silt nylon. Lovely. No sunset time lapse today, unfortunately. Hopefully, the showers are blowing over and by the morning it's a few clouds, but mostly sun. Pretty windy up here, and I've got that wall there to protect me as well, so. So I'm probably going to put the burner on, have a bite to eat, and hit the hay. Catch you in the morning. Morning, folks. It's 7 o'clock on Sunday 29th, I think. it might be the 30th today. Can't remember. Yeah, what a night. it absolutely poured down with rain until maybe 11, half 11. I probably went to sleep at about 11, woke up at 2, and it had stopped, so somewhere in then. But the wind didn't stop until 5 o'clock this morning. Absolutely battered. It's definitely tested this tent quite well. And I'm impressed. Hopefully you've got some of the noise at least on camera, because that was unbelievable. So, there we go, folks. All packed away. Left no trace, as always, apart from some footprints in the bog. There's Pudjmuir, covered in cloud. And then hopefully you've seen the time lapse of the sunset. Sunrise, even. There you go. That was Coll de Gats. This section of the path is rugged, I think is the word. So, here I am, base of Pudjlofra, however you pronounce it. Going up there, to the top, then back down this path, and through that gap in the wall, and then it's just down to that track, and back down through the canyon, the gorge, to Sawyer in the truck. So I think, all being well, I'll probably be back at the truck by one-ish, I think. We'll see how that goes. If you can make it out, but there's like farmland down there. That's the farm at the top of the gorge, which then goes down into Soyer, which you can see there. And then there's Port Soyer over in the background. Puigmayor still shrouded in cloud. Embassment de Cuba, and the trail that I walked across to get to that yesterday. Here we are, back at that break in the wall. I'm going to drop down now through the woods, hit the track, and it's an easy stroll from there. That really is one of my favourite sounds of all time. If I own this farm up here, I'd definitely open up a campsite. It is absolutely perfect up here, absolutely amazing. It's just made for it. It's incredible. Might see if it's up for sale. See if I can convince Claire to move up here.